Hey guys, so I read this comment and I actually like it a lot. I want to touch it, but I can't. So, Tears of the Kingdom, I made a video about the timeline and how it doesn't make any sense. About they say, oh, it's in the Imprisoning War, but not the Imprisoning War that they actually told us about in Link to the Past. But this comment, and when you think about it, so. Before we start, keep in mind that there is when time travel is involved, wonky stuff happens. We have Ocarina of Time, right? Splits into the adult timeline and the child timeline and the downfall timeline. So at the end of Ocarina of Time, I know this, I feel like I'm repeating this all the time, but people who are new to this, there's three timelines. So you start in the Ocarina of Time. You're starting in essentially the child timeline. Your child Link, do your little spiritual stones and all that. You get to the Temple of Time. You get Link. It's sealed into the Sacred Realm for 7 years, and eventually becomes the adult timeline. So there's 7 years in between. So you have the child timeline and the adult timeline. The adult timeline, Ganondorf is powerful, and he's become basically ruler of Hyrule. In the end, you defeat him. In his tower, becomes Ganon. You defeat Ganon. The sages band together, seal him up in the Sacred Realm. Job well done. At the end of the game, Zelda says, "Yeah, all this is my, all my fault. I'm gonna send you back to being a kid. Let you relive your childhood. Let you make up those lost 7 years." So Link is removed from the adult timeline to go back to his original timeline. Well. The adult timeline leads to Wind Waker. Ganondorf sealed up. Eventually, over time, that seal weakens. He comes back, and with no hero, the goddesses have no choice but to flood Hyrule to, stop evil. Child timeline, Link gets back to his time, and presumably, as soon as he gets back, goes to Hyrule Castle, meets with Zelda, and says, "Hey, that guy in there, he's a bad dude." They learn that. Yeah, he is a really bad person. He's not loyal to Hyrule at all. They arrest him, send him to Arbiter's Grounds for execution, leading to his containment in Twilight Realm after he kills the Sage of Water. They find out, oh hey, we can't kill this guy. He's got the power of the Triforce of the Triforce of Power with him, so he can't do anything to this guy. So let's just seal him up in the Twilight Realm and hopefully that gets rid of him. And then there's the third timeline, the downfall timeline, where at the instead of winning that battle against Ganon at the very end, Link dies. He's defeated. Ganondorf wins, which leads to a Link to the Past, the creation of the Dark World. So after that, after Link falls, the sages still seal him up in the Sacred Realm, and while he's there, he's building up his forces. But after he launches an assault, gets sealed up, launches another assault from the Dark World, because people go there looking for the Triforce and everything, and he kind of turns them into monsters, and he launches his assault from the Dark World, where he comes back because there's like these opening like an opening where he can get through, and then he kind of gets sealed back up again for good. Because the sages make sure, hey, let's close all pathways this time. But there's three timelines. This one, kind of what I said the last time with Skyward Sword. So if we assume Tears of the Kingdom isn't a reboot, there may have been a timeline split in Skyward Sword caused by the time travel at the end of the game. There is time travel, they have the Gate of Time. You use the Triforce, you destroy Demise, but then Ghirahim kidnaps Zelda, goes through the Gate of Time into the past where Demise still exists. In the present era of Skyward Sword, the Triforce is used to destroy Demise. The people of Skyloft descend onto the surface, and the Kingdom of Hyrule is founded by Zelda. Zelda, Link, Groose. All the Zelda games that were released before Breath of the Wild and Twilight, Tears of the Kingdom take place after this. So, pretty much how we expect. That's where Minish Cap happens, stuff like that. So that's the timeline that has Vadi and Majora and, you know, Maladus and all those other villains that we've been introduced. The past era continues on, and with Demise being defeated, the events of Skyward Sword never end up playing out, and the people of Skyloft don't end up descending onto the surface for many generations. Over time, either some people of the sky evolve into Zonai, or the Zonai arrive from somewhere else, and Demise is eventually reincarnated as Ganondorf. Because Demise, even though he's not there, and he's sealed in the sword, Demise is more of a concept of hatred and malice, and as long as there's malice in the world, Demise will always be there. You can seal him up, you can destroy him, you can do whatever you want. It's kind of like the Dragon Balls. In Dragon Ball GT, you have the Shadow Dragon saga. So basically, over the years, the wishes that they make on the Dragon Balls, even if they're good, you know, for good intentions, if they start holding negative energy. So even if you're doing something positive, those Dragon Balls start containing negative energy. And eventually, they use the Dragon Balls so much that this negative energy broke the Dragon Balls and the Shadow Dragons emerged. And then once the dragons were defeated, it kind of purified them, kind of resetting them. So even getting rid of the dragons, it still had the possibility, which is why Shenron at the end was like, yep, I'm taking the Dragon Balls. You people are overusing them, and this is just going to happen again. So I'm taking them. So Demise is a concept of hatred and a physical form of hatred and malice and all those negative emotions. So even if he's gone, that it's all those feelings, that it's always going to be there. So over time, evil Zonai or Zonai from somewhere else, and Demise eventually reincarnated as Ganondorf. The events of the past in Tears of the Kingdom then play out from here. This may also explain the absence of the Triforce in Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom, as the temple containing the Triforce in Skyloft was never opened and could have simply went undiscovered. That's how they got rid of Demise in Skyward Sword. It was basically in the temple of the goddess, and then they used it to get rid of Demise. And so in the past, the temple, the Triforce is still there. They haven't opened it up because, you know, that's not how they got rid of Demise in that timeline. Link had to go into the past, and he had a one-on-one duel with Demise himself. So there was no wishing for the Triforce for him to the Triforce to take out Demise. He had to go into the past, and he fought Demise himself. Because really, the only thing that Triforce did was kind of like the sealed grounds, the imprisoned, was Demise, and it just crushed him. So, yeah, but they had to use the Triforce. And then in the past, he goes into the past, and they seal Demise in the Master Sword. And then goes back, and safe to assume that Demise has pretty much been extinguished from the Master Sword. But there is time travel. So you have two timelines from Skyward Sword with different outcomes. So it's safe to say that it is possible that the Skyward Sword, where Demise is sealed up in the Master Sword, the Triforce is never used, the Skyloft is never brought back down to the surface, so the people are still living up there, and we saw how advanced they kind of were. They had entire cities floating up there. How technologically advanced they were. So considering how advanced the Zonai are, it's safe to say that possibly the people of Skyloft over time became Zonai. Maybe being so close to the gods gave them more godlike power. It would also possibly explain their darker tones of skin. You know, you're up in the sky that long, something's bound to happen. But then again, evolving into different species, look at the Zora. The Zora are fish. But then they evolved into Rito, which are birds. So people in Skyloft starting out as humans, but then evolving into like goat, cat people. As weird as it is, again, Zora fish turned into Rito bird. So, or maybe it's the other one where the Zonai came from somewhere else. Because we know that it's the land of Hyrule, not the world of Hyrule. So there could have been other places at this time that have been established for a much longer time. And maybe the Zonai came from a kingdom somewhere else. Maybe they were like a wandering tribe and decided to live closer to the heavens or something like that. Because again, we know Hyrule is not the only place. We go to Holodrome, we go to Lebrana. Those are in Hyrule. Or not Hyrule, but in the same, you know, on the same planet. So it's safe to say that maybe if the Zonai did come from somewhere, it was from just a distant land where they just, because they look very primitive, you know, very tribal, but also they're advanced. You know, they have all these amazing magical abilities, and they have these constructs that are like servants for them, and these tears that, you know, stones that they can use with amazing power. So it's possible that the Zonai did come from another land. It's possible that the Skylothians became the Zonai. But whatever the case is, it's safe to assume that if Ocarina of Time can have a split in the timeline, Skyward Sword with its time travel causes the same effect. So you have one timeline that leads to pretty much every game that we know of, and then another timeline that may just have Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom in it. So that could explain how there is an imprisoning war. Because again, if it was in the timeline we know, it should be called the Great Imprisoning. You know, if there's multiple imprisoning wars, then separate them. Call Imprisoning War number 1 or the Great Imprisoning War. But it would make sense for it to be called the Imprisoning War if this was indeed the first one in a separate timeline. So, and I've seen people, a lot of people with the Triforce. The Triforce is always going to exist. The Triforce has existed since the beginning. Once the goddesses left the world, they left behind the Triforce. So no matter what, the Triforce is going to be around. In Tears of the Kingdom, Breath of the Wild, it may not be physically there that we can see, but you can see it everywhere else. Their clothes are still emblazoned with it. You still see it around Hyrule. So even if it's not physically there, because pretty much every game we've seen the Triforce physically in some kind of way. In Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom, we just see images of it. Now, at the end of Breath of the Wild, Zelda uses presumably the power of the Triforce in order to destroy Calamity Ganon, but it's not the physical Triforce. It's just her kind of harnessing her divine power. I mean, you see the thing with the back of the hand and everything, but we don't see the physical Triforce. So people were like, oh, maybe it just doesn't exist anymore. No, it does exist. And if it's still in its original hiding place up in Skyloft, which would explain why no one's seen it. Everyone knows of the Triforce, but it's just hidden still. And it's going to continue to be hidden because Skyloft is still up there protected by Cloud Banks. And of course, now if this does happen... Because it would be hidden, but now this place is... But then again, Skyloft could actually just be completely different than what we're seeing now. Because what's... If they're able to get into the sky now because it's going to become visible, like all those islands, what's stopping them from going up there and trying to find the Triforce and actually finding it? But then again, you need certain things to get in there. So, I mean, I don't think they could bust their way in. So, it might still be protected, even if Skyloft became visible. Because some people are thinking that these islands are just like remains of Skyloft or something like that. But hey, it's just a theory. A game theory. But it's a theory that I do like. It's just that Triforce bit at the end. How it's still hidden. And that Skyloft would still technically be hidden. But now we have these islands that have opened up in the sky for us that we can see. Which would essentially mean that Skyloft is also visible. Unless this is Skyloft, or just remains of it. But if that was the case, we would... Because we know Skyloft was above Hyrule. So this would have to be Skyloft, which would mean that the Temple of the Goddess, which hid the Triforce, would have to be up there. But we haven't seen anything, so... Just gets curiouser and curiouser. But I do like this idea that it's a split in the timeline from Skyward Sword. It does make a lot of sense that way. Or again, it's just a reboot. You know, they're rebooting the series, and every game up until this point has just been a legend. So, there's that. But thanks to Kurochi for making this comment. It kind of explains a lot, you know, if it was true. I doubt it. Like I said, I think... It's just more of a theory. And I think if someone was to ask Nintendo, they'd just be like, oh, it's in whatever timeline you want it to be. You know, it's like, oh, it has Koroks and Twilight Princess artifacts and this and that and stuff from the Downfall timeline. So it's wherever you want it to be. Like, okay, can you stop being so vague and give us an answer? The players want an actual answer, not some, oh, it's whatever you want it to be. So I've read a lot of comments the past couple of days after this, and a lot of them are long. It's too long to where it's like, I'm not going to read it all. I'm happy for you, or I'm very sorry that happened. But I read this, and I'm like, that makes sense. People still don't know where. You probably will never figure out where it is. The idea that it's its own separate timeline from Skyward Sword makes a lot of sense. But, yeah, if we can figure out this conundrum that Nintendo's put us into, that'd be great. So let me know what you guys think. Just too much. This is what happens when you play with time travel, guys. You just get wonkiness. We already saw what happened with Ocarina of Time with three separate timelines. Now we've got two separate timelines with Skyward Sword. You're killing us, Smalls. Anyways, let me know what you guys think. That's going to do it for me. You guys know the drill. I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.